हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 7। सो टुडे द टॉपिक इज मीथेन। हाउ डज मीथेन प्ले एन एक्टिव रोल इन ग्लोबल वार्मिंग? इंक्रीजिंग प्रपोर्शन ऑफ मीथेन इन द एटमोसफियर लीड्स टू मैनी एनवायरमेंटल चेंजेस एंड ग्लोबल वार्मिंग टू। इन द ईयर 1750, the proportion of methane was 315 ppm. In the year 2005, this proportion increased to 1764 ppm. Thus, there is a massive increment in the proportion of methane. This is due to the following main reasons. You can see in your textbook, one table is given. Exhaling of animals and metabolism process release 14 crore ton methane. Then paddy cultivation 15 crore ton. Decomposition of the biodegradable waste 7 crore ton. There is an urgent need to decrease the amount of methane released in the air. Now things to know. All the things used by human in one day has 80% of the air in it. A man breathes 22,000 times every day. In this way, a man consumes 16 kg of oxygen from the environment per day. Now about the nitrous oxide. The proportion of nitrous oxide has increased from 270 ppm to recent 319 ppm. Chlorofluorocarbon, that is CFC, due to the use of foam, plastic, refrigerators, AC circuit, aerosol spray, that is the minute particle having the size ranging from 1 micron to 10 micron is known as aerosol, etc. There has been an increase in the CFC. Now, things to know for your knowledge. As per the resolution passed by the UN on 23rd January 1995, 16 September is observed as the ozone day. After 1980, year 2007 was the hottest year. Now, the effects of global warming. Changes are observed in the growth and development of the vegetation. Certain species of birds are now disappearing, such as sparrows and vultures. 2000 glaciers of Himalayas have melted. Now you can see the picture. Gradual changes observed in the glaciers. See, 12th March 2001, then 1st July 2003. And then 19th June 2006. Now, following were the destructive effects or the consequences of the global warming, like effect on vegetation, birds, animals, water resources, agriculture, effect on soil, seasons, coastal areas, and the effect on human beings. Now, non-conventional sources of energy. You can see the picture given here, book, solar energy, wind energy, biomass and tidal energy. These are the non-conventional sources of energy. Now, measures to prevent global warming. Reduce the use of sources that release carbon dioxide. Afforestation and conservation of forest should be done. Growing trees help to reduce carbon dioxide. Avoid the use of plastics. Optimum use of manure and pesticides. Adopt organic farming, that is use of green manure and cattle manure. Add biotic in the food for animals. Optimum use of household appliances. Proper use of means of transport. Check the growth of human population, design the buildings with sufficient ventilation to save the electricity, increase the use of eco-friendly papers, grow plants and trees around your houses, make optimum use of natural resources, use petroleum product judiciously, use water carefully, practice rainwater harvesting, increase the use of CNG and non-conventional sources of energy. Now, things to know. To make 1 ton of paper, 4400 kW electricity, kilowatt, okay, 30,000 liters water and wood of 11 trees is required. Now, global policy to protect environment. On realizing that human activities are the root cause of destruction of the environment, the countries of the world gathered at Stockholm, the capital of Sweden, in the year 1972 to think of ways to protect the environment. Another convention was held at Rio de Janeiro, that is Brazil. In the meeting held at Copenhagen, capital city of Denmark, in the year 2009 to discuss global warming, it was observed that the developed nations are not accepting the carbon cut, that is the technique to reduce the emission of greenhouse gases. And the developing nations were increasing pressure for the reduction of emissions of greenhouse gases. It was decided to give an aid of $100 billion for the development of developing nations. In this meeting, 59 research papers from 45 countries were presented, and through it, the leaders of the world were made to think seriously regarding the changing climate. On an average, a citizen in the world emits 4.5 metric ton carbon dioxide. Indian citizen emits 1.2 metric ton carbon dioxide. Other developing nations release far lesser carbon dioxide gas. Large amount of concessions should be given for development, and more restrictions should be imposed on the countries like the USA. As an average, American emits 20.6 metric ton carbon dioxide. Now, student, I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you.